被你的英雄忘掉了整场决定的后遗，在心中的路那里是今天的暗淡，
songs together.
6 years.
Nigh on 6 years now.
Fucking hell.
How did you guys meet?
We first met, but we didn't really meet. Like, I'd seen him because I was like a little boy in the crowd in a pub in Liverpool and he was playing guitar in a really awful band called the Roosters. Like, we both had like songs. I wasn't a particularly good guitarist, but I knew a few chords and I had ideas for songs, and they seemed to fit together with like the half ideas he'd had. So even though we didn't particularly like each other,
was that two one-legged men having
to two one-legged men
strap themselves to each other,
split down the middle,
so they could stand up, and after a while learn to walk.
We didn't really have an idea of sound or even a band, really. We just always believed in quite an old-fashioned way in songs. Complete faith. It's what we lived inside. It's the only thing we had, really. We didn't have religion, and I don't know, we had love affairs and whatever, and drugs, but nothing that really captured you completely, and songs did that. I'd always lived inside songs, but, and so had he. And then we created our own ones, and that was that. And that
was everything. What songs did you live in? Which songs?
Any songs that you find yourself singing, for even a snatch of a second a day, you know?
Yeah. I think when I was about 13, I got stuck in Venus in Furs for about 2 weeks. Got awfully cramped in there.
I got stuck in Rent by Pet Shop Boys, because my friend's dad used to play in a car. You took me to a restaurant on Broadway, bought me caviar. Look at my hope. Yeah. Probably best not break over that.
On Broadway.
I suppose we, in the back of our minds, we thought one day we might get a record deal or have our own instruments and stuff. And then when we seen the Strokes, it was almost like proof that you can still, they seem to be authentic, the music seems to be genuine and like strong songs. So they were like an example, like you can still do it, and they looked like they were mates and they're enjoying it, and it was just cool, you know, it was, seemed natural. So it's proof that you can still do it, you can still get away with it. You know, just stick together, keep going. So it was, in a way, it was not influential, maybe on the way it happened for other people and why they chose to like us even, you know. But more inspirational than influential, yeah. I think, yeah. Like when we first, the Strokes first came along, our manager, like, she was supposed to be our manager, but we hadn't seen her for 6 months. And all of a sudden, Strokes came along, and she brightened up pretty sharpish.
Yeah, she did.
Because she thought, oh, I know some boys who dress.
She smelt
like
a few bob, I reckon.
Yeah.
So yeah. In terms of inspiration, then
you didn't even like them.
No, that's because
I was saying, oh, there's this wicked band, you got to hear them, and they heard it, and he went, that's rubbish.
Yeah, and because it sounded something like badly recorded Velvet Underground, and that's saying something. It's Velvet Underground, you know, worst recorded band in history, but it's a great effect.
Like your hand in the fire, you told it like an Amazon. But I've never seen no smiles in the barrel of your gun. All I've ever seen it through is one. There isn't a tear. Now tell me, baby, how does it feel? I know you're like a roll of the limousine wheel. They all get so wrong. Yeah. matter when I'm dreaming of you? What can I do? I don't want you.
What'd
you say?
This song is from
Coral.
Great.
I wrote that song. I sold it to
when you. I'm stealing from you.
Yeah, that's what the promo says. Yeah, but how did that happen?
Well, Pete makes something up and then he says it's an interview.
No, it's just sometimes you hear a song and you think, oh shit.
Yeah.
You know, you just recognise the melody.
Do you see more similarities with the Coral than with the White Stripes, for instance?
I don't
see more similarities with the Coral than the White Stripes, no. I'd say, like, we're equally as different from the Coral as we are from the White Stripes. But completely different songs, completely different style to the Coral and to the White Stripes, in a way. Maybe we've got more of a similar guitar sound to the White Stripes, I don't know.
Yeah, it's like
comparing an oak tree to a buffalo or something.
But suddenly you have all those bands and they're all part of what is
called. Yeah, but one man somewhere has sat down and written, you know, the new rock and roll revolution. What?
Buffalo.
Yeah.
Which is nonsense.
Maybe it is, I don't know, I'm not bothered about it.
But it helped you.
Well,
yeah, that's
maybe
the deal. The deal
maybe
is,
it look, if maybe it was the kiss of death.
Oh, Lord.